In the Bridge Academy's 8th grade system, in the 4th book, we have a task which is drawing the human face. So now, drawing the human face seems to be a very difficult, very challenging affair. Actually, like any other drawing that we have been doing so far, drawing the face too is a geometrical pattern. So simple forms, geometrical pattern, measurements, angles. If we follow this right, drawing the face is going to be very easy. First, we'll draw the facial structure, fill it up with the elements in the face. Then we will go to the individual pieces, individual features, and we'll see how to draw that. So that is the eyebrow line. The lower quarter line is the nose line. So as we said, this is just a guideline to draw a face. Depending upon the individual's face and features, the measurements will change a little bit here and there. So that becomes the hairline. The face ends here. The chin will come out slightly. Now, we take these three quarters and we draw a circle there. We will talk about the usefulness of this circle later. That is the width of the face. If the height is divided into 4, the width is 3 parts of that. Then we draw a slanted line which comes inside and we have the chin. This could be varying. We will be changing it into many divisions later. At this level comes the ear. Up to the nose. We said this is the eyebrow line, so we draw the eyebrow. The eyebrow is a long line out and a long line out, up, a short line coming down. The distance between two eyes is one eye level. That's the measurement that we take. So we draw a rhombus. What is it? Short, long, almost equal, short, long. And we have the tear glands. After this, when we are drawing with the pencil, we'll be drawing very light lines. You'll have to remember that. Then curve it out. You'll have to remember that the lower lid line comes under the upper lid line. It doesn't join like that. It comes and joins like that. That part you will have to remember. Then we draw the hood of the upper eye. If you are going to be drawing a circle for the eyeball top will be touching the hood of the upper eyelid. We will erase that slightly That is the pupil. Leave a little bit of highlight and fill up the eyeball with whatever shade you want to give. There will be a slight shadow at the top. We have done the eye. Now, we take that off and we take that off too. Not completely, we need a guideline. We can take it off when we are ready to finally draw the line. We have a V shape, two tiny horizontal lines, two slightly bigger vertical lines. Now we draw the eyebrow like that. The eyebrow hair lines will be slanting out. Remember that. And the slant will increase. Now we can erase this part. This part is taken away slightly. When we are doing a pencil drawing, we can erase it with the side of the eraser and then we show the nostril like that. We curve out the lines. We curve that out. And here, we don't show the entire line like that, but we show it just this much. Now between this, we take 1/3 from the nose line and draw a straight line. The end of the lips will be a plumb line dropped from the center of the eye. That will be the width of the lips. Again, I remind you, this is just a guideline. The faces could change slightly from person to person. These are basics to get things right. Now, it comes up to that. Here, the center, we draw a V. And we draw a V there. We connect it like that. We don't go beyond it, we just stay within it. A small horizontal line. Again, this line will go and join inside, slightly inside, like we drew the eyes. Slightly inside. A small crack, and that is the projection of the lip. Now, as I told you earlier, the chin could be coming up a little. So, the jut of this. And we draw the face like that. The bulge of the eye, top of the eye. We said this quarter is the hairline. So, we draw up to that. The neck, shoulder. Now we can extend this to show hair. So, now we know the measurements. 4, 3, where the eyebrow comes, where the eyes come, where the nose comes, we have measurements. Practice this and from there go into individual faces, looking at photographs or looking at people and see what difference is there. When you add the difference, you will get the features right. So this is how you draw a portrait.